So hi all, I'm again here with this set of questions for AS400 interview. So I have prepared this AS400 practice questions with four options. Means they are objective questions. So this is set one where I have these 15 questions. So let me move on to the questions one by one. So the first question is, which of the following is the result of using prefix xx colon 2 on a file definition specification line for a file, file 01, that has one field named field 1? So we have here the question is, we have file name file 01 and has one field 1. Now if I define that file on an fspecs in our RPG program and we use prefix keyword with that, and prefix keyword like this xx colon 2, then what will be the field name? So prefix is basically used to rename the fields. So here I would say file 01 is the name to xle01. So this is not the answer, because in this case the file is not renamed, actually the field is renamed. So just move on to the second option. Field 1 is renamed to xxeld1. Field 1 is renamed to xxfield1. Field 1 is renamed to fxxield1. So the answer is second one, B. This is the correct, because it just replaced the first two characters with xx. So field 1, so fi is replaced with xx, then the new renamed field would be xxeld1. So the answer is this, B. Let's move on to the second question. Given the following hspecs, in hspecs I define date DIT star MDY. So the date format is star MDY. Which of the following conditions test whether a job started prior to midnight and is still running after midnight? So if we basically use percentile date here directly, so what happens, it gives me the system date, not the date when that job was submitted. So to get that date, we have UDate concept. So UDate basically gives us the date at the time when the job was submitted or the job became active. So here you can see if UDate is less than percentile date, but again we cannot compare this UDate with the date because the format is star MDY, and we need to convert that to the date format. So what I am doing, so the second and the fourth answers are not correct. So one and A or C can be correct. So let's see. So here I am not converting this and I am just comparing this with date. So this is the correct answer. First converting this to the date and then checking with this percentile date, current date. So this is something which is correct. So the answer would be C here. So we are basically using UDate and star MDY format and converting that to the date format and comparing whether it is less than percentile date. So it would basically check the date at, so it gives us the date at which the job was submitted, that is prior to midnight. And it will check whether it is still running or not if it is less than percentile date. Now the third question is, which of the following contains only valid file specification keywords? So we are talking about file specification keywords. So it can be any file, disk, workstation, printer. So here we can see on first one, there is ignore. So yes, this is used with the files, like to ignore the required formats which are declared on fspecs as an external sky file. Max device, so this is not used at the fspecs. This is used when we create a display file. So here we define the maximum devices to be used. So this is used with the command. This is not. SFL-LIN again used with the subfile. Record format, so this is again not. So this answer is not correct. Let's move on to the second one. S file is yes used with the fspecs. Call p and include are not used. Call p is used to call the procedure prototype, and include is used to include the file or copybooks. So here again this is not correct. So let's move on to C. INDSP. INFDS is yes used with the fspecs. Prefix is also used with the fspecs, but INDSP is not a keyword in AS400. So that's incorrect answer. Again ABC are not correct. Now if you move on to the D, PGM name, plist, so these are also not there in the fspecs. So I would say that which of the following contains only valid file specification keywords? So answer would be E, none of the above. Which of the following is the correct calculation for adding 23 days to date field cull date? So we have a date field cull date like this, and we are adding 23 days to that date field. So we have an opcode add duration, EDDDUR. So this is incorrect. First one is incorrect, and the A is incorrect, D is incorrect. So we have ADDUR add duration keyword or opcode, which is used to add the days or perform the arithmetic calculation with the date, time or timestamp. So either we can add date, time or timestamp, whatever we want, minutes, hours, seconds, so everything, milliseconds. So here I am adding 23 days. So for day I am using style D, for time I am using start T. So there are like for seconds star S and for minutes like star MN, and for milliseconds is star MS, like this. So yes, you can add 23 days to the current date. So this is the correct answer here. So this is the correct syntax, you can say. If you go and check in your code, so you'll find that this is the correct syntax. So you will use add duration opcode, and then you will add number of days here, then colon, and then star D for day, and then you will specify the field name, that is current day. So this is not correct. If this was star D, then it would be correct, but here we use the full star day, which is incorrect. So the answer is C. Procedure proc 1 in a service program must be called passing to it a 5 position field. So basically we have a procedure in service program proc 1, and we are calling that procedure by passing a 5 position field. Which of the following code segment will accomplish this task? So A, in D specs they defined the field and then calling the procedure and then param A field. So this is incorrect. So this is again incorrect. The same options are there. Let's look into the C, PROC1 PR. So first we define the procedure prototype like this, PROC1 PR, my field 5A, and then stand alone variable and calling call p proc 1 if e. So this can be correct. Let's move and see what is the d1 proc 1 prext pjump proc 1. Okay, so here and my field 5a, a field s5a, call p proc 1 my field. So here if you see it is calling the proc 1, which is an external program, but here if you see it is mentioned that this is a procedure in the service program, so this is incorrect. And again, the second incorrect thing here is like it is using the variable my field, but my field is not defined. This is not the definition of this field. This is just a prototype. The definition is like here, a field can be passed here, but if this a field was specified here, then this would be incorrect. So I think this is the correct answer here, because here we have defined the prototype and we defined a variable, standalone variable, and we call the procedure proc 1 and pass that standalone variable to this. So the answer would be C. Which of the following is the options keyword on a definition specification used to specify? Parameter passing options, compilation options, program initialization options, date format options. So options we use with the parameter passing options. So basically it is used when we specify PR or PI. So on that we specify whether to pass this parameter or not. And like this, what type of parameter it is, star bar size, something like that. So we use basically options parameter on the parameter passing on the D specification, which is saying or defining the parameter passing options. So answer is A. What type of values can be used with the percentile char built-in function, character, numeric, date, all of the above? So we can use numeric here. So whenever we percentile char is used to convert numeric to the character, we cannot use date. First we need to convert that date into the numeric, then we can convert that to the character. So we'll use the numeric. The answer would be, which of the following operation codes is supported in both fixed form and free form slash free form? Call is not supported in free format, because in free format either we don't use call p or we will be using call p. So we will be basically using call p to call a program using the prototyped call method. Even call b is used with the fixed format. We cannot use call b on a free format. Eval r, allocate can be used on the free format. Extract, no, allocate is not used in the free format. Extract won't be used in the free format. So I think eval r is the correct answer here, because eval is optional there in free format, but that must be specified in the fixed format. But eval r is not provided in the free format. So we need to, which of the following operation code is supported in both fixed form and free form? So we need to specify eval r there. So once we specify eval r there, then only we would be moving the right variable from right, eval r. Which of the following statements will extract the state code MA out of the text field city ST, which contains Boston MA? Move L city ST state. So this is incorrect. We would not be using this move L. Eval state percentile trim L city ST. Again, this is not correct. Then we are doing the substring from 8 to 2. Okay, then we are doing the trim R from 8 to 10. basically we need to extract MA. So for extracting we will be using the substring. So substring is this one. So we will be doing substring from 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, from 8th position till length 2. So 8 colon 2 on the CTST variable, we'll be doing substring and we will be evaluating that to the state. So we'll be getting the code MA. So basically the answer would be C. Which of the following SQL statements when used by itself in an RPG program can take the place of a file specification, a key and a chain? Fetch, select into, declare cursor, prepare statement. So if I would say that select into would select the field into some variable only, declare cursor would declare the cursor, and prepare statement would prepare the SQL statement to be executed. So the fetch statement is something which is used to fetch some record. So basically doing the chain or on a basis of key. So we can say that fetch is the answer here, which relates to this in RPG. In a D specification, what do standalone and constant describe? So whenever we describe define the variables, we use standalone S, and when we define the constants we use the C. So this is basically defined whether this is a variable or a constant. So this is defined the routine type, data structure type, no, internal data type, no. This is defined the declaration type. So declaration type told us that whether this is a variable or a constant. Answer is A. Which of the following is the operation code extender for not locking a record on a read or chain? So whenever we are doing read or chain and we do not want to lock that record, we would be using extender N, that is no lock. So answer would be B. Which of the following is a file specification keyword that causes a file not to be opened at program initialization? So as we all know that whenever we call a RPG program, and then whatever files declared on the FSpecs, they gets opened at the time of initialization. That is whenever the INGDSR subroutine gets executed. If present, if not, then again also it would, all the files would get open before executing the first statement of the program, that is during the initialization process. So is there any keyword which can stop that, or which can cause that file not to be opened at the time of initialization, program initialization? Yes, we can explicitly open a file by specifying percentile open function or opcode. So here we have a keyword user open, usropn. So we have keyword usropn, which we will use with that file in the fspec, so that the file would not get opened at the time of program initialization, and we will specifically or explicitly open that file whenever we need it. Now what is the purpose of percentile element built-in function? To return the number of used elements in an array? No. So this does not return only the number of used elements. So for example, we have 10 elements in an array and it would return 5 elements because 5 are in use. No, that's not correct. To return the value of the current array index? No, that's not correct. To return the number of elements in an array? Yes, this is correct. The number of initialized element, this is not correct. So answer would be C. It returns the number of elements in an array. Which of the following parameters can be used with the percentile end of file built-in function? So whenever we define or we use percentile end of file built-in function, so what we can do whenever we are reading file, so we can either specify the file name or record format both. So yes, we can define both. Record format name only, no. File name only, no. Indicator, no. So the answer would be C here. Record format and the file name, both can be defined there. So I think I have covered all these 15 questions and discuss the answers of them. And yes, later on you can verify and you can check at your end whether all the answers are correct. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.